And a very good evening to all, and welcome to the webinar on organic social media promotions, co-organized by Urban Skill and Nepal Internet Foundation. So before we move ahead with the session, I would like to tell you briefly about Urban Skill as well as Nepal Internet Foundation. Well, Urban Skill is a knowledge sharing and skill development community wherein we help the young minds acquire knowledge and explore the wide array of career opportunities in the internet world. Also, you can check our previous webinars on our YouTube channel. We'll be providing the link of the same in the chat section while the session begins. You can check out the same. Now, coming to the Nepal Internet Foundation. So, Nepal Internet Foundation is a research and development forum that supports and performs technical and geographical researches in the context of Nepal to build up the reach of the internet and its objective within the country. It is aimed to overcome the digitalization challenges the country is facing and to bring the transformation in the society. So it has been a long time that you people have been waiting for the webinar to start, and obviously you must be curious to know who our speakers are. So within no time, I'll just introduce all our speakers. And I request the speakers to give their appearance while I introduce them. So, now starting with our guest speaker today, Mr. Odell Dias. So, guys, first of all, I would like to introduce you to our guest speaker today, Mr. Odell. So, Odell, with around 4 or 5 years of work experience in the digital marketing industry, has helped brands across multiple niches in both paid as well as organic advertising. Currently, he is a digital marketing manager with a media institute and handles its entire 360 online marketing activities, which includes social media marketing, SEO, paid ads, and much more. Apart from this, Odell is also the founder of rightlydigital.com. RightlyDigital.com is a website that shares tricks, tips, and strategies to help you succeed in digital marketing industry. Odell, you're welcome to the webinar today. We look forward to a great session with you.
Thank you so much.
So heading towards our next speaker, Mr. Vikram Sreshta, who is the president of Nepal Internet Foundation. With over decades of experience and working as a professional digital banking head, Vikram specializes in international marketing and holds extensive industry knowledge in risk management, strategic planning, investments, budgets, financial reporting, and much more. Vikram, I welcome you to the webinar today.
Thank you and namaste.
Coming over to our next speaker, Mr. Jay Podyal, the founder of Urban Skill Community. Urban Skill was also formerly known as Knowledge Cafe. This is to bring to your knowledge. So, Mr. Jay Podyal is a serial entrepreneur and internet governance enthusiast. His core expertise is technology and e-business. He has established many startups and businesses in his 20 years of experience, learning from both success and failure. He has ventured into several niches like domain name investment, education, software product development, e-commerce, healthcare, publishing text and videos online, and internet governance. Mr. Jay Podyal, I welcome you to the webinar today.
Hi, thank you.
So, within no time, we shall start with the session. And now I would like to hand over to Mr. Vikram Sreshta, and I would like to invite him to deliver the welcome speech and mark the beginning of the webinar.
Thank you and namaste. People influence people. Nothing influences people more than a recommendation from a trusted friend. A trusted reference influences people more than the best broadcast message. A trusted referral is the holy grail of advertising. Mark Zuckerberg, founder, CEO of Facebook. Thank you very much, Divya, and good afternoon, everyone, participating on this virtual webinar initiated on collaboration among Nepal Indian Foundation and Urban Skill. I am Vikram Sreshta. I have the privilege of being president of Internet Foundation in Nepal, where our mission is for research and develop firm that supports and performs technical and geographical resources in context of Nepal to build up the reach of internet and its objective within the country. First of all, this is first of its kind with the theme of organic social media promotion. I would like to welcome our special speakers, Mr. Odell Das, founder of RightDigital.com, and my very good friend, Mr. Jay Powdel, founder of Urban Skill, with us with this webinar. Distinguished guests, dear colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, this is my pleasure to share that the Nepal Indian Foundation set an objective contributing towards the transformation of society to overcome the challenges of digitization in Nepal. Our goal is to ensure that the use of internet shall be used the liberty in secure environment and a secure environment and easy accessibility, supported by the law and continuous of Nepal. We envision a society where the people are empowered by the use of internet and its individual, regardless of the country, location, language, age, or income, shall be able to communicate and collaboration with each other to improve their lives and community. Today's agendas reflect a view of supporting this concept and ideas with organic social media and promotion to reach to customer and build engagement organically. Appreciating the concept of you won't build a house without a plan. So why spend a tons of resources and money on social media if you aren't sure what you are building? I would like to add that I think the most important thing here is for all of us to participate openly and fully, all on an equal footing with one another. We are actually all here to learn, understand, and share individual thoughts and experience, whether we are on a speaker or as in the audience. And there is no great difference between speakers and those of you who are participating in the audience. So especially for the young people, youth and newcomer here, I would like to remind you of the opportunity and also the obligation to really occupy this event and to make it your own. Thus, knowing your resources, your budget, your team and your accomplishment is the wise planning for successful decisions. It's fantastic to have nearly around 50 participation. We are here for this webinar representing in the audience today, and this is fantastic number. Without further ado, now I would like to request our honorable speaker to share their knowledge, ideas and experience on today's topic, that is organic social media promotion. Thank you very much for this opportunity, and welcome everyone. Over to Das, please go ahead.
Thank you so much, Mr. Bikram Shrestha. I'm really happy and really excited to be a part of this and to share everything that I've learned over the years with you all. And I also like to thank Mr. Jay Podial and Urban Skills for giving us this platform to, share our skills to people. And I'm hoping that someday even the attendees will be speakers at Urban Skills. So that's my aim at the end of this webinar. So I'll quickly start, and I think I'm going to start sharing my screen now. So you all will be able to have a look at what I'm going to teach you. Okay.
Then I would just like to interrupt here. Before you start, I have something to say to the audience. So, dear participants, so this is for you all. If you have any questions in the middle while Lodell takes the presentation, please type it in the question answer section so that we can take it up at the end of the presentation. Because in case you type in the chat section, that may be overlooked. I hope I'm clear to everybody. And now you can start.
Okay. Or my Hindi is a little bad, so I will try to speak in Hindi too. But I hope, you all can manage with English. I will mix a little bit here and there. But mostly I am going to stick to English for this specific presentation. So I hope that's okay with everybody. So I'm going to start. So I'm going to share my screen right now. You all will be able to see my screen, okay? So just let me know if you all can have a view of my screen right now. Probably Divya, you can let me know if they are mentioning it on the chat system.
Yeah, sure. I'll let you know.
Yeah, because I will not be able to have a look at that. So just let me know if everybody can see. Yeah. So y'all can see my screen?
Yeah, your screen is visible, I think. Can we have a couple of answers in the chat section if you are able to see the screen? I think सबको स्क्रीन दिख रही है.
ओके. अगर सब लोगों को स्क्रीन दिख रही है तो मुझे बोल देना, ठीक है?
ओके.
ग्रेट. सो आज हम लोग ऑर्गेनिक सोशल मीडिया प्रमोशंस के बारे में बात करने वाले हैं. सो वी विल लर्न व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इज ऑर्गेनिक सोशल मीडिया प्रमोशंस एंड बाय द एंड ऑफ दिस वेबिनार यू विल अंडरस्टैंड द डिफरेंस बिटवीन ऑर्गेनिक एंड पेड प्रमोशंस. ऑर्गेनिक प्रमोशंस और पेड प्रमोशंस के बीच में ये डिफरेंस क्या है आपको वो पता चलेगा. द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक प्रमोशंस इन क्रिएटिंग ब्रांड अवेयरनेस. ओके. हाउ टू क्रिएट एन इफेक्टिव सोशल मीडिया स्ट्रैटेजी. सोशल मीडिया में स्ट्रैटेजी कैसे बनाते हैं, ऑडियंस से कैसे टारगेट करते हैं. यू विल लर्न ऑल ऑफ दीज थिंग्स. चैलेंजेस इन ऑर्गेनिक प्रमोशंस. अगर आप ऑर्गेनिक प्रमोशंस करते हो तो उसमें प्रॉब्लम्स क्या आती है. व्हाट आर द लिमिटेशंस ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक प्रमोशंस. आफ्टर दैट यू लर्न अबाउट द डिफरेंस बिटवीन अ फेसबुक पेज और अ फेसबुक ग्रुप. फेसबुक पे दो तरह की चीजें रहते हैं. एक फेसबुक पेज है और एक फेसबुक ग्रुप है. सो यू विल अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन अ फेसबुक पेज एंड अ फेसबुक ग्रुप. एंड लास्ट यू विल अंडरस्टैंड एंड यू विल लर्न व्हाट and how to approach Instagram. So Instagram dusra platform hai, abhi Facebook ke sath tie up hua hai, so you will know how to create brand strategies on Instagram. Okay, so we will start with organic and paid promotions. Okay, so organic social content is the content that is posted on social media for free. For example, sharing a status on Facebook, tweeting on Twitter, sharing an image on Instagram. You don't have to pay any social media platform to, do this. So, आप जो भी Facebook, Twitter में और LinkedIn में share करते हो, उसको organic promotions बोलते हैं. आप Facebook या Twitter को पैसे नहीं देते हो वो promotion करने के लिए, वो post करने के लिए या video upload करने के लिए. So, that is organic promotion. Paid social content is shared with spend behind it to help you reach a larger audience. Paid social posts will show up in the feeds of whichever audience you decide to target. You can target audiences based on demographics, locations, interests, and more. So, paid promotions के लिए आपको Facebook या Instagram को पैसा देना पड़ेगा, and then you will get to choose who you want to target. अगर आपको you want to target someone between the age of 20 to 25, paid promotions में आप target कर सकते हो. आप मल्टीपल टारगेटिंग कर सकते हो. तो दैट इज द एडवांटेज ऑफ पेड प्रमोशंस. नाउ ऑर्गेनिक सोशल पोस्ट विल शो अप इन द फीड्स ऑफ पीपल दैट फॉलो यू. आपके जो फ्रेंड्स है, दोस्त है, इफ यू अपलोड समथिंग यू विल दे विल सी योर पोस्ट. योर पोस्ट विल बी शोन टू मोर पीपल एज योर ऑडियंस शेयर्स एंड एंगेजेस विद अदर पीपल. तो अगर आपने एक मीम शेयर किया और आपके दोस्त लोग ने लाइक किया, कमेंट किया, शेयर किया, So their friends will also see the post. The chances are higher. But if nobody comments on your post, the chances are that, you know, only a few people will see it on social media. So that is the difference between organic and paid promotions. Now, why is organic promotions really important? According to a survey conducted by Animato, 58% of consumers visit a brand's social pages before visiting their website. And since last year, that's an 81% increase. Okay. So even if you decide to buy a product, chances are you will go on their Facebook profile to see what they are posting. And that is where the true power of organic promotions comes into play. Agar brands ne sirf paid promotions kiya, so, you know, as a customer, you might find something fishy if they are not there on social media. So that is why brands and more brands are starting to do organic promotions as well as part of their social media strategy. Okay. When these consumers visit your social pages, it's the organic content you have shared that they'll see. So agar aap un log ke social media pages pe jaoge na, to aap jo un log ne organically post kiya hai, wo dekhoge. You will not get to see their ads at all because the ads are shown only to people they have targeted. So now that we know the difference between organic and paid promotions, how do we create an effective social media strategy? Hum log strategize kaise karte hai social media, successful hone ke liye? We learn that in the next few slides. Okay. The first thing, okay, that is very important, is to write a brand summary. Before you start promoting your business online, you need to know a few things. One is write a paid summary that identifies your goals on social media and how it connects to your business. So say what you want to achieve by creating the social media pages. You need to figure that out first. You can write primary goals and objectives and what you want to achieve. Okay. And focus on a few social media channels. Do not try to be everything on all social media channels. So this is very important because many brands, what they do is they will, try to be on every social media channel and it does not work. Each social media, platform is designed for a specific target audience. So choose the one that is perfect for your brand. Audit your competition. Iska matlab hai, see what your competition is doing. Apna competitors kya kar rahe hai, wo bhi audit karna padega. If you want to succeed in social media, you need to check what your competitors are also doing. Check their brand social medias, check what sort of posts they are posting. Are they posting videos? Are they posting images? What is the content they are posting? Check how many people are engaging on their posts. When you are creating your posts or when you are sharing something, the only way that should matter that it's working for you is the engagement. Engagement should be the number one way to measure ROI of social media advertising. So engagement ka matlab hai comments, likes, shares, what a customer is saying. If you post something on social media on Facebook, agar comment customer ne like kiya hai, kuch acha comment diya hai, so that is defined as engagement. Okay. Now, when you're creating a social media platform, there's something called the GSOT method, okay, which is goals, strategy, objectives, and tactics. Goals, these are your broad social media outcomes. Strategy is the approach you will take to accomplish your goal. Objectives are the measurable steps you will take to achieve your strategy. And tactics are the tools or tasks used in pursuing an objective related to a strategy. So if this is a little too much for you, main aapko next slide mein example leta hu to aapko samajh mein aayega main kya bol raha hu. Okay. So say for example, mera company, maine Rightly Digital found kiya hai. So what was my goal? I have put it in an example over here. So my goal is to make a digital marketing course that will help people achieve their marketing goals. Okay. What will be my strategy is to increase the amount of content I publish on social channels where I talk about digital marketing, social media marketing, search engine optimization, SEO, content writing. So my strategy would be all content digital marketing ke upar, social media ke upar mein dal do. My objective, increase the unique visitors from social channels to course page website by 50%. Now, the thing is, agar mujhe कोर्स सेल करना है तो मेरा वेबसाइट होना ही चाहिए, ये बहुत ही इम्पोर्टेंट है. तो वन ऑफ माई ऑब्जेक्टिव कुड बी सोशल मीडिया से जो भी मेरे कोर्स के लिंक पे क्लिक करे और मेरा सोशल लैंडिंग पेज पे आए, वो मेरा गोल रह सकता है. आई कैन कीप दैट एज एन ऑब्जेक्टिव बाय लुकिंग एट हाउ मेनी पीपल आर कमिंग फ्रॉम माय सोशल मीडिया चैनल्स. एंड टैक्टिक, माय टैक्टिक इज टू द यूज ऑफ डिजिटल मार्केटिंग इन्फ्लुएंसर्स, लेवरेज द एक्सपोजर विद ब्रांडेड हैशटैग्स एंड बिहाइंड द सीन्स कंटेंट यूजिंग इंस्टाग्राम स्टोरीज, फेसबुक लाइव एंड ट्विटर. नाउ इसका मतलब है I can try different methods to achieve my goals, you know, my final goal. I can get influencers, digital marketing influencers का मतलब है जो digital industry में, जैसे जय सर, you know, they are big on the digital industry. So I can get them to talk about my courses. You know, I can use the correct hashtags, you know, that will help reach more people on social media. I can use stories on Facebook and Twitter and all of these things. So just remember, GSOT is one method that you need to use if you want to succeed in organic social media. Now the fourth point is develop buyer's persona. Okay, a buyer persona is a fictional representation of your ideal customer. So what that means is that suppose aapka ek business hai, you know, homemade soaps ka business hai. So your buyer persona, you will write who is the ideal customer. Maybe women between the age of 20 to 20, you know, 30, who are interested in organic soaps. You know, they don't want harmful products, you know. So you have to be very detailed in making a buyer persona. Before you start marketing, marketing se pehle hi aap do ya char buyer persona banaye and write. So if you can see the example here, this is one example of a person who's facing who's a normal person, but they have mentioned each and everything about this person, like the demographics, the behavior, their motivations and goals. Okay, see, Jim is a train driver in London and loves to travel. Due to working part-time, he often goes away and explores new places in Europe. He always leaves booking his travel and accommodation to the last minute. His age is 55, he's married and he has one child. His profession is train driver and he's located in London. What are his problems in life? It's expensive last minute travel and accommodation. Has to look at multiple sites to find the best deal. Struggles to book both travel and accommodation on the same website. And his goals are to find affordable travel and accommodation. Find travel and accommodation at short notice. And spend as little time on booking as possible. So you can see, you have to make a detailed bio of your customer, ideal customer. When you do this, agar aap ye karte ho na, aapko pata chalega what type of content you need to share on social media that would help a customer understand you and engage with you. Lekin आपको ये सब चीज अकेले नहीं करना है. देर आर फ्री टूल्स ऑन सोशल मीडिया, द फ्री टूल्स ऑन द इंटरनेट दैट यू कैन यूज. कैनवा है, गूगल एनालिटिक्स, बफर, हैशटैगिफाई, मेलचिम, बिटली, गूगल ट्रेंड्स, बसुमो. अगर आप ग्राफिक डिजाइनर नहीं है, लाइक यू नो यू आर ऑन योर ओन, यूर अ ओन बिजनेस ओनर, यू कैन नॉट अफोर्ड टू बाय अ ग्राफिक डिजाइनर, यू कैन क्रिएट योर ओन ग्राफिक डिजाइंस यूजिंग कैनवा. ओके, so that is something that I will show you, if time permits I'll show you how to use Canva as well at the end, and how you can create a Facebook page as well. Google Analytics is used to track what visitors come to your website. Kitne sare log you know social media se apne website pe aate hain, you can track that using Google Analytics. Buffer is used to schedule your social media content, so you can आपको हर टाइम हर दिन पोस्ट अपलोड नहीं करना पड़ेगा. इफ यू कैन इन एडवांस ओनली, यू कैन मेक योर कॉन्टेंट फॉर वन वीक एंड यूज बफर ऐप टू स्केड्यूल इट. सो यू कैन बी ट्रेवलिंग बट योर पोस्ट आर ऑटोमेटिकली गेटिंग शेयर्ड ऑन सोशल मीडिया. हैशटैगिफाई यू हेल्प्स यू यू नो फाइंड रेलिवेंट हैशटैग्स ऑन सोशल मीडिया. MailChimp is an email marketing software. Bitly helps you reduce the long URLs of your website to a small neat link. Okay, so like that there are many tools you can use. you can check all of these tools that I mentioned here, or you can search for more tools on the internet, and there are many free tools. Another sixth point, make sure you always measure the success of your social media efforts. Okay, measurement is the only way to know you are on the right track. So there are two types of measurement, quantitative measurement and qualitative measurement. Quantitative means jo aap dekh sakte ho numbers mein, like website analytics, number of likes, comments, shares, signups, wo sab numbers mein rehta hai. Aur qualitative measurement means what type of comments, aapko comments kaise aa rahe hai, positive hai ya negative hai, positive reviews aa raha hai ya negative reviews aa raha hai. So these are all the comments, okay, that you can check. So quantitative tells you what happened, kya ho raha hai, and quantitative tells you what happened, qualitative tells you why it happened, okay? So I hope you all understand the challenges, the advantages of social media and the tools that you get, but there are certain problems in organic promotions as well. Koi challenges bhi hai so organic promotions mein. Organic reach on social media is how well your posts perform without any money behind them. And with algorithm changes, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, the organic reach is getting less and less. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, उन्हें अभी they are focusing on businesses to invest money. तो अगर आप social media में organically post करते हो, तो chances are इतने लोग को आप target नहीं कर सकते. Social media is not built for businesses. Social media platforms are built for connecting two or more people in a relaxed fashion. They were not primarily built for businesses. Social media actually क्यों क्रिएट किया गया था, क्योंकि लोगों को कनेक्ट करना था अपने दोस्त के साथ, बिजनेसेस के लिए नहीं था, ये पोर था सोशल मीडिया का. सो व्हेन यू आर ऑन सोशल मीडिया, यू आर नॉट थिंकिंग ऑफ परचेसिंग समथिंग, यू वांट टू यू नो चैट विद योर फ्रेंड्स, यू वांट टू लाइक फोटोज, यू वांट टू वॉच फनी वीडियोज. सो टू गेट समबडी टू बाय समथिंग वाया सोशल मीडिया इज अ चैलेंज. ओके, द स्टेट ऑफ माइंड इज नॉट राइट, लो रिटर्न ऑन इन्वेस्टमेंट. ROI from social media marketing is lowest in online marketing strategies. You have to put both time, effort, and money to really make things work. If you do not post or engage with your fans or people on a regular basis, there surely will be a decline in your followers and engagement. ये क्या बोलना चाहता है कि when you try to sell something on Facebook, Instagram, chances are लोग खरीद के mindset में नहीं है. They will not buy unless they are looking for something. So बहुत टाइम लगाना पड़ता है. योर क्रिएटिव, योर इमेज हैज टू बी रियली गुड एंड योर टारगेट ऑडियंस हैज टू बी रियली गुड टू मेक एन इम्पैक्ट. और एग्जैक्टली टाइम कंज्यूमिंग है. बिग मिसकंसेप्शन इज सोशल मीडिया इज फ्री, बट टाइम इज नॉट फ्री. तो अगर आपको एक भी पोस्ट बनाना है तो आपको रिसर्च करना पड़ेगा, आपको क्रिएटिव बनाना पड़ेगा, आपको राइट हैशटैग्स राइट टाइम पे पोस्ट करना पड़ेगा. सो ऑल ऑफ दिस इज वेरी टाइम कंज्यूमिंग, बहुत टाइम लगता है ये सब करने के लिए. ठीक है दिव्या, इफ देयर आर एनी चैट्स, इफ दे आर नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड और एनीथिंग, जस्ट टेल मी बिकॉज़ आई डोंट हैव एक्सेस.
या ओडेल, देयर इज अ रिक्वेस्ट फॉर यू टू रिपीट द टूल्स वंस अगेन विद सम एग्जांपल्स.
ओके,
रिक्वेस्ट फ्रॉम ओमकार आचार्य दैट प्लीज कैन यू प्लीज रिपीट द टूल्स वंस मोर विद पॉसिबल सम डेमोंस्ट्रेशंस.
Okay, so most of the tools that I mentioned here, what I'll do is I'll show it to y'all at the end, so y'all will get a better understanding. Canva is a graphic design tool used to make creatives for free. You don't need a graphic designer if you know how to use Canva. But of course, if you have very complicated things, then you need to hire a graphic designer. But basic to mid level ke liye Canva chal jayega. Okay. Google Analytics is a tool that will help you track how many people are coming to your website. Okay, agar aapke paas website hai to aapko Google Analytics ka code dalna padega wo website pe. From then you will be able to see aapke email marketing campaign se log aapke website pe aaye hai ya aapke social media channel se log aapke website pe aaye hai. So you will get access to from जिस जगह से दूसरे वेबसाइट से लोग आपके वेबसाइट पे आ रहे हैं, यू विल गेट एक्सेस टू ऑल ऑफ दैट. नाउ बफर इज अ टूल वेयर यू कैन यू नो शेयर योर सोशल मीडिया, यू नो स्केड्यूल इट इन एडवांस ओनली. ओके, सो लाइक दैट आई विल शो यू अ फ्यू इन इन यू नो प्रैक्टिकली, सो यू ऑल विल अंडरस्टैंड अ लिटिल बेटर, क्योंकि पीपीटी से आपको थोड़ा परेशानी होगी समझ में के लिए. ठीक है, so I'll just go to the next slide and then we'll come back to that. Limited to only social media platforms. When you do social media marketing, you are essentially using social media platforms like Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram or Twitter to market and build your brand. You are not using your own platform, you're using social media. So it is limited to only social media. SEO और SEM में क्या होते हैं, आप अपने वेबसाइट पे काम कर सकते हो. SEM में आप पेड प्रमोशंस के द्वारा लोग अपने वेबसाइट ट्रैफिक अपने वेबसाइट पे डाल सकते हो. लेकिन सोशल मीडिया में क्या होता है, इफ अ व्यूअर वॉचेज योर वीडियो ऑन फेसबुक, दे आर ऑन फेसबुक ओनली. अनलेस दे क्लिक ऑन अ लिंक, यू नो यू आर लिमिटेड टू फेसबुक. सो दैट इज अ डिसएडवांटेज. Another disadvantage is that different platforms require different strategies. Instagram requires a different strategy, Twitter requires different strategy, Facebook requires different strategy. So when you're making your marketing plan, you need to, you know, be flexible for all the strategies, okay, for all the platforms. And of course, paisa aur time, ye dono bhi lagte hai. Paisa maine bola hai paid promotions ke liye, to paisa lagega, lekin agar aapko paid promotions nahi karna hai, still you will need a graphic designer or someone like that, you will have to pay money. Okay, so now we'll go to the next topic, which is Facebook page versus Facebook groups. Okay, and we'll understand what is the difference between the two. Just give me 1 minute please. Yeah, so Facebook page pages enable public figures, businesses, organizations and other entities to create an authentic and public presence on Facebook. Unlike your profile, Facebook pages are visible to everyone on the internet by default. Dekho, Facebook profile mein kya hota hai, agar aap friend request bhejte ho and your friend accepts your request, only then they can see your details. Facebook page mein aisa nahi hota. Once you create a Facebook page and you share it, people can just view your page if they like it. Okay, it is open to all. It is not a closed entity. You and every person on Facebook can connect with these pages, become a fan, and then receive the updates in your news feeds and interact with them. Okay, Facebook groups are the place for small group communication and for people to share their common interests and express their opinion. Groups allow people to come together around a common cause, issue, or activity to organize, express objectives, discuss issues, post photos, and share related content. ये groups थोड़ा अलग है Facebook page से, क्योंकि ये community जैसा है. For example, in a Facebook group, अगर आपको access मिला तो आप भी status message डाल सकते हो, आप media डाल सकते हो, आप interact कर सकते हो the you know other group members के साथ. लेकिन Facebook page में one way in a way one way होता है, क्योंकि the owner of the Facebook page has more control compared to a Facebook group. A Facebook page gives businesses the ability to talk directly to their following and hopefully to some of those individuals intended to become a part of it. Brands have a chance to send specific messaging to people that matters most to them, that is their customers. And because of a Facebook page, you can run Facebook paid ads to drive engagement and raise brand awareness by page boost campaigns at a lower cost. एक चीज बहुत ही इम्पोर्टेंट है, अगर आपको Facebook पे paid ads करना है तो आपको Facebook page create करना ही पड़ेगा. Without a Facebook page, you cannot run paid ads. तो ये बहुत ही इम्पोर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट है. तो अगर आपको फ्यूचर में paid ads करना है तो Facebook page और बहुत ही इम्पोर्टेंट है, आपको तो create करना ही पड़ेगा. Whereas Facebook groups, as mentioned earlier, are mostly used for teams, but can also be used for customers to drive engagement, get feedback, knowledge sharing in a community and environment. Okay, तो मैं example देता हूँ. अगर मैंने अपना business start किया है Rightly Digital, मेरा Facebook page है, लेकिन और मैंने बहुत सारी courses भी sell किया है, लेकिन अभी मुझे फीडबैक चाहिए अपने कोर्स स्टूडेंट से, तो मैं एक फेसबुक ग्रुप क्रिएट करता हूँ, वहां पे माई स्टूडेंट्स कैन शेयर व्हाट दे हैव लर्नड टू ईच अदर, इवन आई कैन शेयर विद देम, आई कैन शेयर फाइल्स विद देम, दे कैन टॉक टू ईच अदर जस्ट लाइक अ on the same lines of a WhatsApp group, slightly different, but on Facebook. Okay, so that is the difference between page and groups. Groups are more for community to get feedback. Agar kuch log ne bola ki, you know, we want something more with videos. So then that will help me learn, okay, mujhe aur videos banana padega mere course ke liye. So that is how Facebook groups are a little different from Facebook page. Okay, so now that we've learned everything about Facebook, we need to understand what is Instagram as well. Okay, Instagram is a primary mobile and visual sharing application. Okay, now Instagram is perfect for fashion, health, personality development, makeup, food and luxury, and other such industries. Not a very good platform to market your blog. अगर आपका personal blog है तो Instagram इतना अच्छा नहीं है, लेकिन that depends, okay? वो depend करता है आपका brand, blog क्या है, what you know niche में है. And Instagram बहुत ही casual platform है compared to all other social media. Instagram most casual Instagram ही platform है, ठीक है? But what is the purpose of Instagram? Okay, the purpose of Instagram is to showcase your products or service, build your community, increase brand awareness, showcase your company cultures or values, advertise to potential customers, increase brand loyalty, and share company news and updates. So Instagram is also a very good platform to have in conjunction to Facebook. Because abhi dono is bought by Facebook itself, so you definitely should consider being on Instagram as well. So there are different ways you can post on Instagram. There are single photos that you can post, there are multiple photos, there are videos. This is only 60 second videos. You cannot post more than 60 second on Instagram. If you want to post more than 60 seconds, you need to create a IGTV platform which is linked to Instagram in itself. Over there you can post up to 60 minutes, okay? And you can share stories on Instagram in the form of photos and 15 second videos. You can link your blog to a story if you have 10,000 followers. So Instagram mein agar aapka follower reach 10,000 hai, to aap apne website link ke liye bhi website link stories mein dal sakte ho, okay? And the last thing is Instagram has direct messaging. फेसबुक में मैसेजिंग कैसा रहता है, इंस्टाग्राम में भी है डायरेक्ट मैसेजिंग, तो आप उसको भी यूज कर सकते हो. सो हाउ टू क्रिएट एन इंस्टाग्राम बिजनेस अकाउंट. यू फर्स्ट यू कैन यू नो द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ क्रिएटिंग एन इंस्टाग्राम बिजनेस अकाउंट इज दैट यू कैन ऐड योर कॉन्टैक्ट डिटेल्स इजिली. अगर आप पर्सनल इंस्टाग्राम अकाउंट क्रिएट करते हो तो यू कैन नॉट ऐड योर कॉन्टैक्ट डिटेल्स. The second thing is that Instagram business account पे आपको analytics information मिलता है. You will get information of how many people have viewed your post, how many people have liked your post, how many people you know have bookmarked your post. That means saved it for later. As well as people can identify you as a brand. Okay, so you have to create an Instagram account and convert it into a business account. Okay. To create it, you just need to create an Instagram account, then go to settings, and in settings there's an option where you can convert it into a business account. It is not difficult at all. So how do you set up a good Instagram profile? This all of these you know is what I told you back in the start, where you create your bio. So you need to create your bio and description, upload a good profile picture, upload the link of your website. If you have a business and you've created a website, you need to upload the link of your website. And the last, which is the most important for all social media platforms, keep it active. बहुत लोग क्या करते हैं, उन लोग social media पे आ जाते हैं और फिर you know motivation जाता है. तो don't give up. Starting में आपको engagement नहीं दिखेगा, लेकिन time के साथ आपका brand awareness you know it will work. So be active every day, post every day. That is very important. Okay. So what are the marketing plans to have a successful Instagram account, first you need to decide on the theme of your business. What style of content are you going to send or share on Instagram? Is it going to be educational and informational? Is it personable, behind the scene content, user generated content? Suppose a customer likes your product, will you take their review and post it on Instagram? You can do that as well. Walkthroughs and demos, how to use your product, videos of how to use your products, jokes and memes. Memes right now are crazy. Sab log ko memes pasand hai. So there are brands that are even using memes for marketing, and it works very well. And community stories, customer stories. Agar aapka customer base acha hai, to what are the stories that they have to say about your product? You can use this on Instagram. Decide on your style. What are your brand colors? What is the type of font that your brand uses? What are the filters that you use? What are the type of captions? What are the hashtags, okay, that you're going to regularly use? And Instagram pe minimum of 10 hashtags you need to use, okay? Composition means the kind of angles or the kind of structure that you're going to set on your Instagram profile. Main future slides mein aapko explain karta hu, aapko samajh mein aayega main kya bol raha hu. See, for example, agar aap ye dekhoge, this is an example of a very successful company called Paperboat. This is screenshots of their Instagram profile. Okay, so if you notice, you can see there is a theme and a style of their posts. So you can also check on Instagram and follow their page. They are really good. You will understand what I'm talking about when I say follow a theme, style, composition on Instagram. Chumbak is another fashion company that also has a specific style. Okay, so if you look at this, you will understand the colors kaisa hai, accessories kaise use karte hai. It follows a theme. Okay, so I hope that is clear in terms of Instagram. You can also use the strategy for Facebook as well, more or less. Some of the strategies that are shared for Instagram can be implemented on Facebook too. Because even though Instagram is a little different, but if you follow this path, you can replicate it and check how it works for other social media platforms. So the next thing is that you need to create a content calendar. Content calendar ka matlab hai, har din aap kya post karne wale ho? What are the themes that you're going to post about? If you see this screen right now, day one is post something inspiring, day two post something educational, day three tell a story with your photo. So if you create all of this in advance for your brand, agar aap khud ke liye nahi kar rahe ho, agar aap freelance kar rahe ho, so you can do that for your brand as well. Isme kya hota hai, there's a marketing plan beforehand and you know what to post. Confusion nahi hota hai. And most agencies do the same thing. They have a content plan for every brand, okay, and it helps them decide what they want to post in advance. So if you create your Instagram account and convert it into a business, you will get to have access to see what are the kind of followers that you're getting. Agar aap screenshot dekhoge to aapko dikhega ki 604 clicks to your website. Maximum followers from United States, Canada, Japan, etc. With the help of this, you can understand where your target audience is and what you need to do to focus on that target audience. So to grow your followers on Instagram, what you need to do? You need to start following relevant accounts and their followers. Okay. If you have a product is of shoes, go to your competitors' Instagram profile. See who they are following, see who their followers are, start following them, start posting regularly, use hashtags. You can use the Hashtagify tool to search for relevant hashtags, use quality hashtags on your post, collaborate with others. If you have your competitor, if you'll have a good relationship, you all can do a brand collaboration. You can collaborate with influencers as well. Jaise maine pehle bhi bola tha, akela kuch nahi karna hai. You can have partnerships with other people and help each other. You can have contests and giveaways on Instagram, or even on Facebook and Twitter for that matter, and get more engagement. Giveaways and contests really work. like tag your friend on Facebook and like share this Facebook page or Instagram page with a picture of both of y'all, something like that. You need to think about you know, what type of contest you want to organize and create a contest like that. Okay, so this is what I wanted to show y'all in terms of my presentation. I hope you all enjoyed this, but I will also show y'all how to you know, create a Facebook page. Divya, we have time for that, right?
Yeah, we have time for that.
Okay. So I'll just show you quickly how to create a Facebook page. Okay. And you just need to implement whatever I shared on the slide. I think that, you know, this slide will be shared with y'all as well. So y'all don't have to remember it by heart. Y'all can just follow the techniques that I've created for y'all. So when you go to your Facebook profile, there's a page section on the left hand corner. You can click on it. Now, if you already manage pages, you will get to see all of this like this. But some of you all might be first time users. So you all might not see this. These are all the pages that I manage. Okay. On the left hand side, you will see something called create a new page. Okay. So you click on create a new page. So this option pops up over here. Okay. So I will just write a page name. Okay. Right now. So you need to fill in all of these details. I hope you all can see all of this. Okay. Just let us know in the chat section if there are any problems. This second option, I'm just, you know, creating a category, maybe education. I've named the page name Digital Marketing Man just for an example. So just to, you know, create a pseudo company that is related to digital marketing. Okay. And here you need to write a description. So I'm going to write Digital Marketing Man is your one-stop place to learn everything about digital marketing, like SEO, SMM, content writing. See, it is very important to fill this description because it helps with, you know, finding your brand on Facebook as well. Okay. So right now I'm just going to keep it short, but I recommend finish the entire character limitation. Okay. When you create. So then you hit create page. Okay, and we'll just wait for it to load. While we're creating it, I'll show you about Canva as well that I had spoken about in my slides. So you'll learn about what I'm actually talking. Okay, so you see this prompt, Digital Marketing Man was created. Now you can add images or go to your page to add more details. Okay, so it's asking me to add a profile picture. This is very important. I need to add a profile picture in order to, you know, make my business more relevant. So this is a site called canva.com. It's a free tool. You can sign in using Facebook. Okay. And sign up with Canva. If you don't have a graphic designer, it's okay. You can use Canva. Okay. So once you sign up, you will reach to this screen. I just click on create design. And then I need a logo for my company. So I'm going to hit logo. I'll click on logo. Okay. So I'll reach this page. My internet is a bit slow, so it's taking time. But if your internet speed is good, agar aapka internet acha hai, toh you will get to see this fast. Okay.
So there is a request from one, from Vikram, that can you please elaborate on Facebook, that he has Facebook has launched just shops to bring more business online. So
yes,
elaborate on this topic.
Okay, so now Facebook is trying to, you know, make everybody stay on its own platform. Okay, that is one thing that Facebook is trying its best to do. So what they are planning to do right now is to get merchants on to Facebook itself. Currently, what's happening is that everybody depends on Google to, you know, get information. And Facebook does not want that. Facebook wants people to stay on Facebook and possibly even purchase on Facebook. Okay. So if you have a Facebook business page, you can add a Facebook page shop. Okay. You can then, this selection is used to list your products you are selling, selecting, and connect with more customers on Facebook itself. So you can create a, you need to have a Facebook business page first. Okay. Then and only then you can add the Facebook page shops. Facebook page shops has certain requirements. Okay. You need to, your shop must be able to sell only physical items. You cannot sell online services using Facebook page, Facebook shops. Okay. Page shops, only physical services. And they, Facebook has certain terms and conditions. So when you create a Facebook page shop, you need to agree with all their merchant terms and conditions. And just click OK. Only if you follow their terms and conditions, then you will be able to create the Facebook page shop. OK, so there are certain benefits as well. You can add as many products as you want once you, you know, successfully create a Facebook page shop. You can customize your product inventory. You can organize your products into different collections so that your customers can browse your Facebook page shop by category. If you have different types of products, you can customize it. Okay. If your products are, you know, like if it's an e-commerce company, this is the best option in terms of, you know, create using Facebook to sell products. You can also communicate with your customers via the page. And at the same time, you can get insights as well for every view, click, or purchase for each product. So that is the uniqueness of a Facebook page shop. And like I said, Facebook is getting very smart right now. What they are trying to do is they are trying to make Facebook a search engine in itself. They don't want you to go on Google to find products and things like that. They want people to stay on Facebook itself. So that is why they're setting up these new ways of, you know, getting people to make payments and make purchases within Facebook itself while they're browsing on their social media platform. So I think that, you know, should get you to understand the power of Facebook right now and what is their long-term goals. So there will be a point of time where people will not think of Facebook as a social media platform. They might think of it as a search engine, you know, platform, like just like Google. Okay. So can I continue with this, or do you want more information on that?
Can we have the answer in the chat section? Do you want more elaboration on this, or we shall proceed? Vikram, this question was from you. Shall we proceed? Yeah, Odell, you can proceed. We have the answer.
Okay, great. Great. So, like I said, I'm just going to quickly make a logo. Canva gives you options. You can just click on the option that you want. Okay. Say, for example, I clicked on this one. And what I can do is I can just edit this and change it. Okay. You see, I'm just doing this with a click of a button. I am not, you know, I'm not a graphic designer as such. So I am just using drag and drop functionality and typing the content that I want. Okay. Now, what if my brand color is blue color? So I want to change it to blue color. So I click on this. Okay, and then I can just click over here and download in PNG. So you just wait for it. And that's it. My logo is downloaded. I will go over here. I'll add a profile pic. Since it's a business, I'm going to add my logo. Okay, I'll go to downloads. I will wait for it to load because my internet is slow. So you see my logos come over here. And now this part is a cover photo, so I will add that too. Same process, you can go to Canva and you can create a cover picture as well. I'll just show you. Okay, I'll just type over here on the create design option and I will type Facebook cover. So you don't need to only use this for Facebook. If you get a job as a freelance digital marketer, you can even use Canva to create creatives for your brands. A lot of people do that. So if a brand's requirement is not too much, you can use Canva in itself to create custom designs. You don't have to use a professional graphic designer always. There are lots of things. I'm not going to go into detail with Canva because that's not the scope of this webinar. But I will just show you quickly. So I'm just typing. Okay, and here I type maybe my company name or whatever, or my website name. Okay, and then I just drag this little bit. Maybe I don't like the alignment, so I can change the alignment. Okay, and then I just click download again. And I wait for it to download. So it took me how long to create this? I mean, maybe 2 minutes, 3 minutes. And I have my cover photo over here, which I'm going to add now. Okay. So you don't even need to understand what are the specifications. You just create it over here. Click save. Once I do that, I have a Facebook page. My Facebook page is already created. Okay. So now I can, even add a button over here. If I have a website, I can put my contact us option and I can add my website link. If I don't have a website, in this case, there's no website. So we'll just click send a message. So now when a person views, a visitor views my Facebook page, if they click on this, they will go to my chatbot automatically. Okay. So right now the page is completely created. Only some important things that you need to, fill is your contact information and all of this information. It's very important. But practically speaking, your Facebook page is now created. So I can put a status message over here like this and create a post like that. And I put my hashtags. If you all search for this on Facebook now, I think you all should be able to find it. Okay. So this is a status message. I'm sure you all know how to, you all might know how to, create a status message, but this is gone as a brand. Okay. I have not put any image or anything like that right now. Just to make it quicker. But even if you want to create an image, you can use Canva and create an attractive image and, post it on social media, not only on Facebook, on Instagram, on other places as well. So later when you get the time, you need to, click on edit page info and add your own personalized username. Now, this is very important because this will help you get the right URL. So when you're sharing your Facebook link to other people, you will get a customized URL so that it's easy to find you. So always use keywords in order to make it easier for people to search for your Facebook page. What I did was I clicked on edit page info. I reached to this section and I wrote my page name, Digital Marketing Man. And then I click enter. to see if it's available. If it is not available, what you can do is just one. Okay, we'll try now. Just wait. I think it is. Yeah, it is done. Here you can put your phone number, you can put your email ID, you can put your website information. So you need to fill, as a business, you need to fill all of this information and then hit back. It will automatically get saved. So this is how you create a Facebook page, and this is how you start marketing your business on Facebook itself. It's very easy. I am sure that even if you'll try it now, just follow these steps, you all will be able to create it within 5 to 10 minutes, not more than that. So that's it of what I wanted to share. Divya, you have anything to contribute, right? Yeah.
So now I would like to, are you done with the things?
Whatever. Yeah, I'm pretty much done with what I have to share.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. But here is some questions, and Jay Podal pani ununsa. Jay Podal, he is my good friend already. Maile share garisake chu. Jay Podal lai pani hami question garna sakchau. Jay Podal chai Nepali nai ho ra aile aba India ma baseko dherai barsha bhaisakya cha. Any questions you can ask with Jay. Jay chai it's a your digital market ma ali expert ununsa. र कसैलाई क्वेशन सोध्नु छ भने हात उठाउनु भए पनि हुन्छ र हामी उहाँलाई चाहिँ के छ भने we can allow to talk them him or her के क्वेशन छ भने सिधै के छ जयसँग पनि सोध्न सकिन्छ त्यसमा लाग्छ मलाई के छ ओमकार सरको के क्वेशनहरु थियो can you ask ओमकार
okay
yeah so I think Omkar has mentioned what can you please elaborate on emerging most effective trends for digital marketing for different industries like banking, tourism. I think basically what Omkar wants to know is what are the current trends that different industries are using, especially for tourism and banking. So what you can do is you can definitely, before you get into, you know, creating your own type of content, what I had mentioned earlier is always check on what your competitors are doing. Okay, follow 3 to 4 or 5 competitors across different industries, see what they're doing. One thing that I noticed what a lot of the tourism sectors do is that they thoroughly depend on video to tell their stories. They depend on customer experiences. Okay, so this is something that you can definitely consider doing if you are in the tourism sector. Airbnb used to sell you know, post videos about a relationship between the mother and their son while they are traveling across different places, you know, and while they are living in their homes in different locations while they are on holiday and things like that, and they use it very, very creatively. So there is no limitation as such. Go and have a look at all the competitors, make a list of the competitions that you want to target, see what they are doing, see the engagements, see how many comments, what type of content gives you, you know, the ones that are working, you would want to replicate not the content but the style. You might want to take inspiration from it. Okay, and after that it's just experimentation. Banking sector talks about trust, you know, talks about comfort, it talks about ease of banking, especially now due to the pandemic. There's a lot of you know, conversations on social media happening about how you don't need to come to the bank do a funds transfer, you can do it via online banking. So you need to keep a track on what is trending in the market and then create your strategies and your content, because that will always work.
Okay, Adel, we have a couple of more questions. I'll take it for you. You can answer them.
Yep.
I think this was when you were explaining about Canva. So this question is from Anil Mahajan. can we design flyers that can be used in social media through tool tab? Do we need to create account for that?
I'm sorry, I couldn't hear you clearly, Divya.
The question is, am I audible now?
Yeah. What's the question?
The question is from Anil Mahajan. Can we design flyers that can be used in social media through Tools app? And do we need to create account for that? This is, I think, in regard to the Canva
app. With regards to Canva, you can use Canva to create flyers. You can use Canva to create Instagram posts. You can use it for social media. You can use it for print creative. So Canva is one awesome app for digital marketers right now. It's not only limited to social media. So you just, like I showed you, right? When in the create design button, click on that and just search for what you're looking for. Okay. Just type the keyword, or you can just browse through Canva and you will get all the options there.
Okay. Yeah. So before I take up the next question, I have an announcement for the attendees. Dear attendees, if you want to ask question, if you want to speak out and ask the question, you can please raise your hand and we'll give you the mic access so that you can speak out also. So now we'll take up the next question. The next question is from Someshwar. This is, which social media platform is suitable for virtual assistant business for lead generation and also for business mentor?
See, the thing about, virtual assistant apps, I'm guessing most of these are app-based platforms. You will need to consider investing in paid advertising for it, because there's only so much that organic social media can do. Okay. Since virtual assistant can be used, it depends on your target audience, really. If your virtual assistant makes life easier for company owners, then LinkedIn would be the place where you would want to, provide your ads, because you will find company owners over there mostly. So it depends on your target audience. It all comes to play when you're first creating your product and you're deciding what your buyer persona is going to be like. You need to, list down a couple of customers. Based on that, you will have to choose your social media platforms. So I think if you're looking for a younger crowd to help you, but I don't think younger crowds really use virtual assistant apps. So if you're looking for anything that is related to a younger crowd, then Snapchat, Instagram, these are the social media platforms that will work. If you're looking for business owners, company owners, people who are more professional in nature, then LinkedIn would work. Facebook might work, because there are a lot of people that use Facebook within who are more professional, who are more working target audience. So yeah, so that's the answer. You have to research. Probably virtual assistant, I think LinkedIn might do well. That's my take on it. But again, you will have to seriously consider paid advertising, because social media organically has its limitations.
So we don't have any more questions here. Bikram, do we have questions on the Facebook Live?
Ramesh, ke questions thyo? Agi you can say yes, bhanne kura athyo. Ramesh le unmute garera questions sodna sakinchha. Ramesh lai maile unmute allow to talk garisikeko chu.
Anybody who wants to speak up?
Yes, sir. Bikram sir, namaskar.
Namaskar, Ramesh ji.
Question to khasai chaina sir, tara yo jun aile ko tapai jun presentation cha waha le presentation garnu bhayo ekdam ramro cha haina aile ko sabai bhanda ho bhaneko jun yo canva ko kura garnu bhayo yo chai free graphic design ko lagi online tools yo chai sabai sanga yesko bare ma jankari na bhayeko le yelai chai aliti promote garne ki kasto cha yo company aafai le promote garne ho ki aba तपाईं हामीले पनि यसलाई प्रमोट गर्न सकिने कि कस्तो हो यसको चाहिँ अलि कन्फ्युजन भयो के सबैलाई यसको एक्सेस नहुन सक्छ नि त यो क्यान भएको यो चाहिँ स्टार्टअपहरुको लागि एकदमै बेटर रहिछ के यो चाहिँ तपाईले नि
अझैले यो क्वेशनको आन्सर दिन सक्छ अझै प्लीज यो जुन हाम्रो अहिलेको अझै मेरो साथी हो अझै चाहिँ अलि क्यान्सर भन्न यो जति पनि सोशल साइटतिर हामी आइकनतिर चाहिँ इन्भोल्भमेन्ट छ यो अझै हामीले यो इजीली युज गर्न सकिने खालको हो अथवा लाइसेन्स भर्सन हो क्यान्सर जय
क्वेश्चन के थियो कि हामीले क्यानभा युज गर्न सक्छन् कि नहीं हैन
सो आई मिन कुन कुरा यस्तो हो जो यसमा रुकावट छ पहिले यो बुझ्न पर्यो
It's a licensed version. Your licensed version. No, Canva
is free tool.
Okay.
Canva is free tool. Anybody can use that, right? Agar hajur like a premium option chahiye, like free premium photo, tab agar matlab 5 ya 10 dollar ko plan hoga per month, to buy karna sakincha. Matlab Canva tool like kaunale bhi nahi use karna sakcha.
जस्तो के क्यानमा जस्तो अर्को के टुल्सहरू छ सो द्याट चाहिँ हामीले इजिली युज गर्न सकिने जस्तो अहिले फेसबुकमा अथवा हामीले इन्स्टाग्राममा जेमा पनि युज गर्न त सक्छौँ होइन क्यानमा क्यानमा चाहिँ सजिलो जस्तो मलाई पनि नयाँ लाग्यो
क्यानमा धेरै सजिलो छ आई होप ओंकारजीलाई आन्सर बुझियो
ओमकारको केही क्वेसन छ ओमकार प्लिज राख्न सकिन्छ
गुड इभिनिङ अब स्पेसली अब यसो यो कोभिड पछि चाहिँ अब मार्केटिङको ट्रेन्ड्सहरू धेरै नै चेन्ज भइसकेको छ अब हामी त ट्रेडिसनल मार्केटर्सहरू भनौँ न पिपुलकै जाने अफिसकै जाने अप्रोचमा ग्रुमिङ भएको हो अब हामीलाई चाहिँ हाउ क्यान बी लर्न फ्रम द बेसिक्स जस्तो चाहिँ अब स्क्रचबाटै स्टार्ट गर्नलाई चाहिँ हाम्रो डेली लर्निङ्सको लागि चाहिँ यहाँहरूले कसरी हामीलाई चाहिँ जानुपर्छ भनेर हाउ डु यु सजेस्ट अर हाउ डु यु रेकमेन्ड नयाँ नयाँ भयो क्या हामी एमबिएस भए पनि वी नेभर ह्याड डिजिटल मार्केटिङ इन आवर एमबिएस एज वेल होइन पनि कहिले थिएन अब यो चाहिँ कस्तो भने वी लर्निङ बाई डुइङ जस्तो मात्रै नै भयो हाम्रो लागि अब यो कुरा चाहिँ स्टार्टअप्सहरूलाई पनि यही प्रब्लम छ क्या तपाईँको जस्तो मैले टुरिज्मवाला मेरो धेरै एन्टरप्रेनर्सहरू चिन्छु उनीहरू पनि दे आर रिलाइङ अन समबडी एल्स के तपाईँको जस्तो भनौँ न गाइडिङ गरिरहेछ उनीहरूलाई एक्ज्याक्टली थाहा छैन कुन इफेक्टिभ छैन टार्गेट मार्केट अघि उहाँले भन्नुभयो टार्गेट मार्केटमा पुग्नुपर्छ भन्नुभयो टार्गेट मार्केटमा पुगिरहेको छ कि छैन होइन उनीहरूको ग्राफिक्स बुझेको छ कि छैन इफेक्टिभ भएको छ कि छैन सो त्यो ट्रेन्डलाई चाहिँ हाउ डु द लर्नर्स बिगिनर्स र चाहिँ न्यू एन्टरप्रेनर्स हाउ क्यान दे बिल्ड अन देयर स्किल्स भन्ने चाहिँ इम्पोर्टेन्ट भयो क्या हाम्रो लागि
लर्निङ जो हो त्यो लर्निङ युट्युबमा यति धेरै च्यानल छन् आइमिन नेपाली भाषामा पनि छ हिन्दी भाषामा पनि मतलब कुनै भाषा हजुरले बुझ्नुहुन्छ त्यस भाषामा च्यानल छ जहाँबाट हजुरहरूले डिजिटल मार्केटिङ लर्न गर्न सक्नुहुन्छ राइट अब कुरो भयो कि एक अन्टरप्रेन्योरलाई जैसे लाइक सपोज कोही ट्राभल एजेन्सी छ नेपालमा या मतलब फरेस्टमा घुमाउने कोही एडभेन्चरको मतलब स्टार्टअप छ राइट अब यो कोभिड भए हुनाले ट्राभल इन्डस्ट्रीमा इम्प्याक्ट छ राइट लेकिन यो कुरा पनि ठिक हो कि आफ्टर कोभिड आई मिन दिस इन्डस्ट्री विल ग्रो अल्सो आई मिन नो बडी क्यान स्टप ट्राभलिङ टु यु नो सो मेनी कन्ट्रिज तो मतलब अब यसको लागि हजुरहरूको पहिला स्टेप के हुन चाहियो कि युट्युबमा त हजुरहरूले डिजिटल मार्केटिङ सम्बन्धित भिडियो हेर्न पर्यो राइट त्यसपछि हामीले के गर्छन् आफ्नो अर्बन स्किलमा हामीहरूले हर महिना 3-4 वर्कसप 5 वर्कसप हाम्रो हुन्छ डिजिटल मार्केटिङको लागि राइट त विक्रम दाईसित कुरा गरेर हर महिनामा एउटा दुईटा वर्कसप नेपाल अडियन्सको लागि पनि गर्न सकिन्छ अरू हामीहरूले मतलब नेपाली स्पिकर जुन मान्छेले नेपाली मतलब अन्टरप्रेन्योरसिपको प्र्याक्टिस गरिरहेको छ आई मिन त्यहाँको नेपाली अडियन्सलाई पनि बुझ्छ अनि इन्टरनेसनल अडियन्सलाई पनि बुझ्छ त तिनीहरूलाई पनि हामीहरूले स्पिकर बनाउन सक्नेछौँ राइट त यही हो बेसिक कि सबभन्दा पहिला डिजिटल मार्केटिङको भिडियो हेर्नुहोस् आई मिन युट्युबमा हामीहरूले पनि कुछ आई मिन भिडियो कम्पाइल गरेर हजुरहरूलाई इमेलद्वारा प्रोभाइड गरिदिन्छौँ त्यहाँबाट हर महिना एउटा वर्कसप नेपाली अडियन्सको लागि हुन सक्छ डिजिटल मार्केटिङलाई फोकस गरेर अनि अन्टरप्रेनरसिपलाई आई मिन लाइक हाउ क्यान बी ग्रो ट्राभल इन्डस्ट्री एडभेन्चर इन्डस्ट्री राइट सो द्याट क्यान बी यु नो फोकस्ड पर्टिकुलरली.
We have one more question from Kalpana Shrestha. My question, she has mentioned, my question is for Ajay ji. That we boost our business in Facebook like the same way in which link we can do, we can boost our business. Would you suggest me?
I mean, what kind of business you have? I mean,
so basically she's asking that Facebook ma boost garae jasto garda aru aru channel haru ma pani boost garna milcha athawa boost nagarikana business lai promote garna sakincha bhanni bujhe maile
sakincha lekin usko ek limitation cha. I mean organic way le pahila matlab kai mahina lagayera organic audience build garna parcha. After that you can build that business steadily. Apart from that you can always boost Facebook ads. तो डिपेंड करता है प्रोडक्ट में, राइट आपका प्रोडक्ट क्या है आपकी सर्विस क्या है बेस्ड ऑन दैट ओके हैंडीक्राफ्ट राइट राइट एंड 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 व्हिच जियोग्राफिक लोकेशन यू वांट टू टारगेट आई मीन नेपाल में एशिया में यूएस यूके में यूरोप में मतलब कौन ठाव में युरोपमै भनौँ न युरोपियन अडियन्सलाई नै युरोपमा भनौँ भने त्यहाँ जो बुस्ट अप्सन हो त्यो अलिकति क्याजुअल हो आई मिन अगर युरोपमा हजुरहरूले फेसबुक एडबाट बिजनेस प्रमोट गर्ने हो भने फेरि पेड एड चलाउन पर्छ नट बुस्ट पेड आई मिन यु क्यान क्रिएट एन एड प्रपर एड मतलब मतलब यस टपिकमा हामीहरूले एउटा वर्कसप गर्न सक्छन् कि कुन प्रडक्टलाई कुन सर्भिसलाई कसरी प्रमोट गर्ने राइट मेरो ब्रिफ आइडिया यो हो कि पहिला हजुरहरूले ट्राफिक क्याम्पेन रन गर्न पर्छ आफ्नो वेबसाइटमा ट्राफिक जेनेरेट गर्नको लागि सो द्याट फेसबुक एआई क्यान लर्न अबाउट युर अडियन्स ओके आई मिन आफ्टर गेटिङ ट्राफिक अप्रोक्स अबाउट 2,000 or 3,000 विजिटर्स देन यु क्यान play around with the you know conversion campaign I mean facebook mai conversion campaign pe nahi chal to conversion campaign run gare ra dheere dheere audience target gare ra matlab slowly te like optimize garne right to yo way le hajarule handicraft item promote garna sakincharu I mean just for your info handicraft item ko dherai demand cha राइट अरु अरु कंट्री लाई कंपेयर गर्दा भने नेपाल को ट्रस्ट पनि छ राइट त्यो मतलब त्यही रिजन ले हैंडीक्राफ्ट को राम्रो प्रमोशन यूरोपियन कंट्री में हुन सक्ने छ.
अर्को हात उठाउनु भएको छ समेश्वर जीले समेश्वर जीले आफ्नो क्वेशन राख्न सक्नुहुन्छ प्लीज.
Yeah, actually, I want to create some videos on business mentoring. So, which is the best tool for video editing other than the Adobe Premiere? Because Adobe Premiere is very professional tool.
See, what we use is we use Filmora 9 actually.
Yeah.
Filmora 9. Mm-hmm. Filmora 9 is good tool, basic tool, and you can perform some advanced action as well. Mm-hmm. Filmora 9 is good, very cheap. I think it will cost you $5 to $7 a month.
Mm-hmm. It's a one-time fee, I think. It's a subscription.
No, one-time fee is I think $49 or $79, I guess. Mm-hmm. But you can go for monthly plan as well.
That is for the additional some transition and all other subscription plan.
Yes, yes, yes.
And suppose I have one business mentoring video. So which social media platform is very useful?
That depends what kind of mentoring business, you do.
I'm business mentoring, all type of business.
I mean, what area? I mean, growth, marketing, sales.
Yeah, it's related to marketing sales, only all related to the business.
I mean, what kind of business? B2B, B2C?
B2B.
B2B. B2B, for B2B, I think LinkedIn is best platform. And
the video is the best option, I think, rather than create
video courses are the best options to do. Apart from that, I mean, if you have good number of modules, then you can upload your course on udemy.com too. People also join there, they have huge, traffic on their website. So I know a couple of guys who have posted some video 2-3 years ago, and they have sold more than 30,000 licenses so far. Suppose for one license there is a charge of even $5. You can imagine the earning of that guy. Actually
I am targeting as of now in India. There is a Hindi language. I am creating all the videos.
Then Udemy also you can do. Hindi language bhi chalega yahan. Udemy also you can do. You can run some community in Facebook as well. Odell, you want to add something on that?
Yeah,
I see, like JF mentioned, if your target audience is B2B, LinkedIn is the best place to do it, and LinkedIn has giving preference to uploading videos directly as well. Simultaneously, you can use Facebook, and there's no harm in putting it on YouTube as well. These are the marketing videos that you're going to put, right? You're not going to give them everything. And then you can lead them to, the platforms that you want to use. Like perhaps if it's a course that you're selling, then yes, you can use Udemy as well. And Udemy is, people trust Udemy because they have been in the market for so long. And, marketing your courses on Udemy then becomes very easy because a part of it is done by Udemy themselves. So I think that's a viable place to consider.
Yeah, good marketplace actually. These videos.
So is there any limitation? One question remaining. Is there any limitation for YouTube video minimum duration? So I am creating actually as of now 2 to 3 minutes kind of video, short video for a specific subject. So is there any limitation?
You are asking for maximum or minimum? I mean
minimum duration.
No limitation actually. I mean, not less than 1 minute. I think at least 2-3 minutes of videos are good.
It's average actually is the 3 minutes.
Ah, good. You have a YouTube channel as well right now?
Yeah, I have created a YouTube channel.
Right.
So one more question. यो युट्युब च्यानललाई बढीभन्दा बढी चाहिँ लाइक बढाउनको लागि आई मिन के भन्छ सब्सक्राइब बढाउनको लागि स्ट्राटेजी के हुन सक्छ र यदि के भन्छ युट्युबलाई चाहिँ अब त्यसबाट चाहिँ इन्कम जेनेरेट गर्नको लागि चाहिँ हामीले के गर्यो भने चाहिँ इन्कम जेनेरेट गर्न सक्छ र कति युजर्स अथवा सब्सक्राइब भयो भने मात्रै त्यो हामी इन्कम गर्न सक्छौँ
युट्युब च्यानलमा के हुन्छ भने कि इट डिपेन्ड्स कि युट्युब च्यानलको निश के हो क्याटेगोरी के हो I mean, suppose a particular YouTube channel is about fashion, right? Then, who is running that YouTube channel? You know my point. You made a YouTube channel and you have someone to make video. I mean, somebody else is anchoring or doing show, right? Yeah, wo video hajur harule aafai banaunu bhayeko. Suppose. म आफ्नो युट्युब भिडियोको स्टार हुँ राइट देन वाट आई निड इन्स्टाग्राम प्रोफाइल राइट इफ आई हेभ माई इन्स्टा प्रोफाइल आई क्यान ग्रो माई इन्स्टा प्रोफाइल अर्ग्यानिकली अपार्ट फ्रम द्याट आई क्यान बुस्ट पोस्ट एज वेल फ्रम फेसबुक द्याट वे आई क्यान पुल माई अडियन्स टु युट्युब च्यानल Right. There are many ways. It depends ki hajur ko product kon ho, service kon ho. Right. Food recipe bhai pasi ramro recipe ko photo haru khinche ra Instagram ma dalna sakincha. Tesko baad tyan ट्राफिक डाइवर्ट गर्ने ओके एन्टरटेनमेन्ट च्यानल भएपछि टिकटकमा भिडियो बनाउन सकिन्छ स्मल टिजर्स देन यु क्यान आई मिन डाइवर्ट युर अडियन्स फ्रम टिकटक एज वेल आई मिन देयर आर मेनी वेज एक्चुली ओडेल यु वन्ट टु एड समथिङ लाइक हाउ क्यान वी ग्रो फेसबुक युट्युब सब्सक्राइबर.
See, the thing about YouTube is there's a different ball game in YouTube completely. You know, you have to be really, first of all, your content, your video quality, your content has to be, even if the video quality is not good, but if your content is great, there are YouTubers who used to take videos from home, from their mobile phones, and they are going crazy. Like Bhuvan Ban is one of those guys who used to take it from his house, I mean from his front camera. So but if the content, so your first aim should be your content has to be of great quality, it has to be engaging. Then there are certain tools that you can use to help you optimize your videos, but again those are just tools that will help you optimize, but your quality, your content has to be good first. Okay, you can use TubeBuddy. It's a plugin that gives you information about competitors and what hashtags they're using. You can copy their hashtags and paste it in your own video. Make sure your descriptions are long form, your descriptions that you're writing. Don't write one line and just exit. Okay, post-production is very important. Explain what the video is about in your descriptions. Write the right keywords. Then use your other social media platforms to promote this video. So you can create a short version of it on LinkedIn. You can upload your video directly on YouTube, on Facebook. If you want views to your full video on YouTube, make a shorter version of it on Facebook and then add the link in the description. You can do the same thing for IGTV. So you need to use all your social media platforms at the same time to promote a specific area. Okay, so that is
Don't go for a paid spammy subscriber. Never.
Yes.
Okay, Odil, one more question. So how do you rank for this social sites, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, ranking from 1 to, 10, or 1 to 5, 6? How do you rank in our part of the world? So which one we have to, most of the in our part, which what is more famous or we have to use?
I'll tell you what social media platform I like a lot is Facebook. But the problem what happens is that we might have our own favorite social media platforms. Like I like Facebook, but I know people who like Instagram more. Okay, so I know people who prefer Snapchat more.
Yeah.
So it all comes down to your buyer, your target audience. Okay, if I'm selling video games and my favorite platform is LinkedIn, and if I'm promoting video games on LinkedIn, I am going to not achieve my target of selling consoles. I would want to be where my target audience is, right? So that could be maybe on Facebook, it could be on Instagram, I could even consider doing ads on Snapchat because that has a younger audience. And it all comes down to creating your buyer persona. So if you create a good buyer persona, you will know automatically which is the best platform to use. So that's what I think is important. You might be favorable to something because you're comfortable with. Try to avoid thinking about you when you're branding your company or you're doing promotions for your company. Think about what your customers want. That should be the main focus.
Okay, so how do you rank 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? Facebook, Instagram.
So I'm going to go with Facebook first, then Instagram. I like LinkedIn too. I think Facebook 1, LinkedIn 2, Instagram 3, then okay. Snapchat.
Okay.
TikTok I'm not going to consider right now.
Okay.
It's not for me. Yeah.
So now we have almost in our event. So I think Ajay, kehi bhannu cha tapailai, because you are the main person for us today. Participation gardai gacha
agi. I'm not the main person. Audience is the main. if audience is not there, I mean, So, see.
I'd like to interrupt. There is a question from Someshwar. He has typed that one last question.
Okay.
Yeah, actually, I see the recording live on Facebook. Is this live on Facebook as well?
Yeah, it's live on Facebook, but we'll share you the link also. I will edit this videos. I have already recorded, and we'll post in YouTube also.
Okay. No, मैं ये पूछ रहा था कि यहाँ पे live का जो option है, अभी live तो नहीं चल रहा है. You will going to edit this and then post it.
अभी live चल रहा है कि आपने कोई controversial सवाल करना है.
नहीं ये लाइव चल रहा है क्या फेसबुक के
ये लाइव चल रहा है शायद मेरे ख्याल से लाइव चल रहा है विक्रम दाई
यस यस लाइव भइराछ तर केन्सर भन्नु पब्लिकली हैन अलिकति उ मात्र गरिराछु पछि हामी पब्लिक गर्छौ यसलाई
ठीक
छ ओके अब के छ हाम्रो अरु क्वेशन्स एउटा के क्वेशन छ यसमा
Divya,
no, we don't
do we have any question?
No, no more questions now. I would like you to say something.
Okay, Jay, like conclude Godam, and we'll close at the end.
Like mera ta yahi point ho ki, I mean, kuch log kehte hain ki nahi, paid se bahut jaldi result aata hai, right? कुछ लोग कहते हैं कि नहीं ऑर्गेनिक इज बेस्ट माई पॉइंट इज कि ऑर्गेनिक इज लॉन्ग टर्म ऑलवेज आई मीन इफ यू आर डूइंग इफ यू आर प्रमोटिंग योर इंस्टा और योर फेसबुक प्रोफाइल इवन योर वेबसाइट इन इन गूगल ऑर्गेनिकली देन इट विल गिव यू गुड रिजल्ट इन फ्यूचर एज वेल अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट इट विल मेक ऑल्सो ट्रस्ट विच यू कैन नॉट सी ओनली सर्च इंजन कैन सी few bot few spider can see ki this particular site is growing organically people are talking about that particular site they are you know spreading social signal by sharing your post or liking it or I mean usme baat kar rahe ho right to organic ki bahut achi value hai aap paid jitna marzi kharch lo to organic bhi aapko करना होता है राइट और टेक्निकली अपने एक्सपीरियंस में जो हम लोगों ने देखा है कि वी हैव सीन कि अगर हम ऑर्गेनिकली भी ग्रो करते हैं तो दैट विल हेल्प इन रिड्यूसिंग आवर पेड एड्स एज वेल आई मीन एंगेजमेंट अच्छा होता है रीच अच्छा होता है तो उसकी कॉस्ट भी हमें कम आती है दैट्स ऑल आई वांट टू से
सो अदर स्पीकर्स आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू डू यू वांट टू से एनीथिंग टू द ऑडियंस नाउ
Yes, thank you very much, Jay Bhai and Odell and Divya and all participation. Thank you very much. यो एकदम राम्रो टपिक थियो हाम्रो लागि नेपालको कन्टेक्स्टको लागि हामी धेरै जसो अर्ग्यानिकको बारेमा हामी बुझ्दैन थियौँ एउटा नयाँ कुरा सिक्यो क्यानभा भन्ने जुन क्यानभा मलाई अहिलेसम्म थाहा थिएन आई केम टु नो द फ्रम दिस वेबिनार एन्ड हाम्रो पार्ट अफ चाहिँ नेपालमा धेरै जस्तो फेसबुक बढी युज हुन्छ र अहिले चाहिँ सेकेन्डमा चाहिँ अहिले इन्स्टाग्राम र अनि के चाहिँ यो टिकटक पनि बढी युज भइरहेछ र टिकटक चाहिँ अब जस्तो भिडियोहरू बनाउने त्यसमा युज भएको छ तर मेरो अर्को एउटा कन्सर्न चाहिँ के पनि छ भने जस्तो नेपालमा हामीले युज गर्दाखेरि यसको चाहिँ प्रपरली युज गर्न सक्ने वातावरण बनाउनुपर्छ अलि जथाभावी युज भएकोहरू पाएको छ त भनौँ न सानो सानो चिज अब त्यतिकै टाइम वेस्ट गर्ने इन्भाइरोमेन्टमा चाहिँ युज गरेर जस्तो देखिन्छ होइन यो लकडाउनले जुन अहिले 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 स्टिल वी आर इन लकडाउन र लकडाउनको बेलामा पनि धेरै भिडियोहरू धेरै कन्टेन्टहरू डिजिटाइजेसनतिर गएको देखेँ र डिजिटलको इन्टरनेटको बढीभन्दा बढी युज भएको देखेको कारण गर्दाखेरि केही कुराहरू जस्तो सोसल साइटहरूमा चाहिँ के पोस्ट गर्नुहुन्छ के पोस्ट गर्नुहुन्न भन्ने पनि अलिकति सेन्समा पनि हाम्रो आउनुपर्छ जस्तो लाग्छ यो सोसल साइट भन्ने बित्तिकै जथाभावी जे लेखेर पनि हुन्छ अथवा जे भने पनि हुने अथवा जे पोस्ट गरे पनि हुने खालको कन्सेप्टहरू चाहिँ कम होस् भन्ने मेरो सोच हो त्यसले गर्दाखेरि हरेक चिजको राम्रो युज गर्न सक्ने वातावरण हुनु पर्यो र क्रिएटिभिटी र नया इनोभेसन खालको इन्भाइरोमेन्टमा चाहिँ केही कुराहरू चाहिँ यो सोसल साइटबाट चाहिँ चाँडै बुस हुने भाइरल हुने खालको इन्भाइरोमेन्ट पनि छ. जस्तो सानो एउटा इभेन्टहरू अस्ति भर्खर एउटा चाहिँ हाम्रो भनौँ रोयल फ्यामिलीको एउटा भिडियो आएको थियो होइन हाम्रो हिमानी शाहको, त्यो भिडियो चाहिँ एकदमै भाइरल भयो टिकटकमा. तर अब त्यसको बारेमा धेरै कुराहरू कमेन्ट पनि आयो कि, त्यसले गर्दाखेरि त्यो कमेन्टहरू कुनै नेगेटिभ कमेन्ट थियो कुनै पोजिटिभ कमेन्ट थियो होइन. तर अब के भन्छ स्वतन्त्र फ्रिडम अफ एक्सप्रेसन भन्ने कुरा पनि हुन्छ. फ्रिडम अफ एक्सप्रेसन भनेको हाम्रो इन्टरनेटमा पनि फ्रिडम अफ एक्सप्रेसन छ. अब भन एउटा राज परिवारले चाहिँ त्यस्तो भिडियो राख्दाखेरि कसैले कमेन्ट गर्दाखेरि चाहिँ यस्तो खालको टिकटकमा चाहिँ किन आएको भन्ने खालको कमेन्टहरू थियो होइन. कसैले चाहिँ एकदम राम्रो फ्रिडम अफ एक्सप्रेसन इन्टरनेटमा पनि यसरी आउनुपर्ने छ भनौँ. अब नेगेटिभ कमेन्ट पनि थियो पोजिटिभ कमेन्ट पनि थियो, तर त्यसलाई चाहिँ राम्रो रूपमा चाहिँ हेर्न पनि पर्ने होला सायद भन्ने सोचले चाहिँ हामी अगाडि बढ्छौँ. र मेरो खालि रिक्वेस्ट के हो भने हामी सोसल साइटमा चाहिँ बढीभन्दा बढी बसिरहन्छौँ. र मैले यस्तो हेर्दाखेरि रिसर्चमा हेर्दाखेरि लगभग हाम्रो सोसल साइटमा चाहिँ के भन्छ भन्दा 18 घन्टा जति चाहिँ सोसल साइटमा चाहिँ युज भइरहेको जस्तो देखिया छ होइन. 24 घन्टामा 18 घन्टा म्याक्सिमम् युज हुने भनेर चाहिँ त्यो फेसबुक अथवा यो इन्स्टाग्राम सोसल साइटहरूमा छ. तर बढी पनि युज गर्नु भएन, यसलाई चाहिँ कम युज गर्ने र प्रोडक्टिभ चिजलाई मात्रै एक्सेस गरेर चाहिँ हामी अगाडि बढ्नुपर्छ भन्ने मेरो सोच हो.
We have one more question from Lipasha Shrestha. That how it's regarding the online payment. What do you think payment before delivery or after delivery, and how can we reduce the return of order? As I do payment while delivery, which is a loss for my business.
Regarding the online payment, what do you think payment before delivery? That means you're talking about prepaid orders basically on e-commerce. See, it depends, I mean, what kind of buyers you have. I mean unki geolocation kya hai, I mean unka persona kya hoga, right? Suppose there are many things. Suppose you are selling garments, or you are selling artificial jewelry, or you are selling fertilizers. I mean, there's a difference actually. Based on e-commerce, particularly in South Asia, here audience buyers used to have, they are comfortable with COD options. Payment after delivery. And to reduce your RTO or your returns, you have to engage with buyer on every stage. While taking orders, after confirming order, you can send them SMS, you can send them email. And if you have a good ticket size, then you can also call them. You can make a welcome call to them. To reduce your returns, you have to engage with your audience, and it entirely depends upon products as well. If price is good, if price is less than what they can buy from outside, then there would be definitely low returns.
Okay, thank you.
And just for you, if you are getting 40 to 50% return, then this is normal. Even 40 to 50% return is also normal in Indian subcontinent actually. Nepal, Bangladesh, Lanka, India. Right. That depends. You have to price right your product basically, so that after getting 40% return, you can make handsome profit actually. If you are getting more than 70% return, then you should change your product, I think.
Okay, yes, thank you.
Okay, so do we have any other questions? I think we are done with all the questions.
Yeah, we are done.
No questions. Okay, so I would like to tell all the participants that we have a message from Omkar Acharya that thank you for the informative session to the facilitators and the moderator. If any online courses would be there, we'd be happy to attend them. So Omkar, we keep on conducting webinars as such at regular intervals, and you can subscribe to our YouTube channel. So we'll be giving you the frequent updates on the same. And also we can send you the emails and you can join our meetup group where we'll keep on informing you about that. And I've shared the link for the YouTube channel in the chat section. You can refer the same. Okay, so I will wrap up now. Thank you so much to the dear speakers and the participants as well for attending the webinar, and speakers for sharing your valuable information with the audiences. So I really appreciate you all being here. So we are done for the day today. And any questions to the attendees, you may write us at hello@urbanskill.com. We will try answering the same and we'll try to take up your suggestions as well. Thank you all.
Yeah, thank you.
So I will end the meeting now. Meeting for Arjun today. Thanks.
Yes, sir.